everyone. I'm Hayana Feltrin, and I'm currently a master's student in the Laboratory of Photobiology at the Federal University of Santa Maria in South Brazil. Today, I'll be presenting to you my work entitled In Silico Identification of Proteins Sensitive to Ultraviolet Radiation in Amphibians. Well, amphibians were the first vertebrates to step on land. However, some factors have been contributing to the decline of their populations worldwide. Among them, climate change, deforestation, and sensitivity to ultraviolet radiation, UV. However, previous studies show that some amphibian species have certain mechanisms to cope with environmental damage, specifically from those induced by solar UV radiation, which is the main environmental genotoxic agent to which these organisms are exposed to. For instance, it was already demonstrated experimentally that the anuran species Boana pucella, which occurs in South Brazil, can perceive UV radiation and also avoid it. Additionally, the perception of UV radiation has been already reported for other amphibian species, and it's known to be related to specific mutations in the short wavelength sensitive opsin 1. SWS1. Therefore, in order to predict which amphibian species potentially have the ability of UV perception, we have used the SWS1 protein sequence of the tiger, salamander, and Ambystoma tigrino to perform BLASTP and TBLASTM searches against other amphibian species. To do that, we have considered both amphibian species with completely sequenced genomes and the ones from the transcriptome shotgun assembly database. As a cutoff, we have retrieved only the best hits considering E values lower than 1e to the minus 15. After that, we have predicted amino acid sequences using the transdecoder pipeline. The key tuning sites, which are involved in the shift from the violet spectrum to the ultraviolet one, have been defined based on the bovine rhodopsin, which have aligned using MEGA7 with the other retrieved sequences to obtain the corresponding amino acid positions. As a reference for comparison, we have used the sequence of Ambystoma tigrino. Our results show that the SWS protein is apparently encountered in 29 species, 14 of them being potentially capable of perceiving UV radiation due to mutations in the key tuning sites regarding the ancestor state of the protein. Among them, we have found 10 species of Anura, 1 species of Caudata, and 3 species belonging to the order Gymnophiona. In addition, the most frequent critical amino acid position for UV perception is E113. The conclusions here presented reinforce the importance of understanding the mechanisms underlying UV perceptions to know how different amphibian species deal with this genotoxic agent. I would like to thank CAPES and SENPQR for the funds, and the organizing team for the opportunity of presenting my work. Thank you for your attention.